was at the very first FintechTO about 3 years ago, so it's good to be back. It's grown a lot. It's great to see how it's grown, like the red branded t-shirts, a microphone, like it's a total luxury at this point. I think this weekend it's obligatory to thank the Raptors. I want to thank them for winning in six, because if it was game seven tonight, there'd be no one here, so I'd be talking to an empty audience. Other than that, I can start with the talk. I'm gonna give a talk about an innovative product that we brought to market last year, actually. The theme is bringing purpose-driven credit to big box, and I'll get into that. But first, if you're not familiar with Financeit, I'll talk about that briefly. So we're Canada's largest point-of-sale lender in the home improvement space, meaning we partner with contractors, manufacturers, and big box stores. So they can offer their customers payment options when they're making huge payment decisions like renovations in the tens of thousands of dollars and break them into small payments. So we're definitely in growth stage now. Thank you, Andrew, for shilling our growth stage and all the open positions that we have. We hit the $1 billion in loans issued target this year, and we're targeting $500 million more for 2019. So things have really been ramping up. We've been growing 35% to 40% year over year about. At this point, we are majority owned by Goldman Sachs as well. They've made two large investments in our company, and they have a controlling share now. And along the way, we've also made two acquisitions. So in 2016, we actually acquired a division of TD. A small fintech at that point swallowing up a division of a big bank, and we bought their home improvement financing assets, which was a competitor of ours at the time. And then we've also bought a company called Senta, who's in the home improvement solutions sector. And that's kind of a new venture for us, getting into lead management and getting deeper into the value chain for our home improvement providers. Like I said, I have been here before, and I did talk about our origin story previously, so if you want to check that out, you can check that out in the FintechTO archives. Today I'm going to talk about a new product we rolled out in October of last year, the Home Depot Project Loan, in partnership with Home Depot, obviously, and it's about bringing purpose-driven credit to big box. Now, what's purpose-driven credit? It's like it says, it's credit with a purpose, right? And for the project loan, the point of this product is if you're doing a renovation and whether you're getting their installation services people in your home or you're going in store 10 times a day, if anyone's ever renovated, they know how often they have to visit the hardware store. This card is meant to support you during that build with the purpose of funding it all. No matter how big it is, we'll fund you up to $50,000. And then helping you through that. And how the card works is basically it's like a revolving credit card for 6 months where you can make purchases up to your limit. And after 6 months, it converts into an installment loan, which is a monthly payment. So it's kind of a hybrid best of breed of the revolving line of credit and then an installment loan, which helps you pay things off more efficiently and you know exactly what your monthly payment's going to be. How did a young Canadian fintech startup end up building a card product for Home Depot? I'm going to take you through kind of the story tonight. It's a bit of a behind the scenes look, and of course it starts with an opportunity, right? And an opportunity was Home Depot Installation Services. They had a problem. They didn't have a very good financing solution, and they had a traditional contractor-driven point of sale solution, which is actually exactly what the traditional Financeit product is as well. But that wasn't a good product market fit for a big box store. It worked well for an independent contractor, but it really didn't work at all at the big box scale. Adoption and support for the product was pretty low, both internally and among the installation network. So they had this product and no one really knew about it or used it. We went in there in 2015, and at that point, we're a young, scrappy, up-and-coming startup, and we pitched them with a demo of our product. And they looked at us and said, well, that's great, but that's what we have now, and it's not working very well. So we actually have this product in the US that is working really well for us. And it was a completely different financial product, like I mentioned. It's that six-month line of credit that converts into an installment loan. And for us, that was like, okay, we can build that. We can totally do that, right? So they probably looked at us, thought we were crazy and weighing over our heads. We looked at ourselves, thought we were crazy and we're waving over our heads. And then we said yes. So we told them, absolutely, we can build that for you. You know, for a big enough opportunity, I would say, you know, you can figure out the details later sometimes if you know it's an opportunity worth pursuing. You're not at the contract stage yet. You know, nothing's been signed. It's going to take some time. Just get your foot in the door, and you can continue having conversations. So here's just a, can't see it right now. Here's just a few things from our pitch decks that we had over the years, just some of the material we presented internally to Home Depot. You know, we had some little slides that we presented them, a vision of what it would be like, trying to articulate what it would look like. And then we moved on to waiting. So at Home Depot, you know, in any big corporation, timing is everything. Home Depot had an existing contract with their existing financing provider. And we had to wait that out. And they finally issued an RFP over 2 years later in Q3 of 2017. But we've been working like 2 years plus on the account to prove that we're up to the challenge, right? In financial services, trust, credibility, stability are key. So, you know, we helped out with trust by, we had worked really hard on our policies, procedures, InfoSec. InfoSec is super important for a big brand like Home Depot, right? Who've had, you know, some public kind of well-documented issues in the past. You know, for stability, you know, we added hundreds of millions in lending capital, and Goldman Sachs took their majority stake in that time to prove that we weren't going to disappear tomorrow, that they could invest in us, invest and finance it, and we were there as a long-term partner. And, you know, with enterprise contracts, it's important to, you know, cultivate key relationships in a big organization like that so the decision makers know who you are when the time comes to make a decision, and our CEO is probably the best person on the planet to do that type of stuff. So we won the RFP, obviously, since I'm here talking about it, but you know, we had to come up in the RFP, we had to have a real solution in place by that point, right? So we had been mapping it out. We decided to extend our and white label our POS lending and servicing platform. Oh, I'm gonna need more than 1 minute. We needed an automated KYC solution, so we partnered with Flinks. We'd never done that before, and we'd never done credit cards before. We'd always done use the EFT network. So we partnered with a company called Marketo, which is a Silicon Valley based company, and we were their first Canadian customer. After that, it was a tough 8-month build, and the product launched in October 2018 with a pilot in Ontario, and it was released nationwide in November. Since I'm short on time, I will take you guys through the screens at this point, so you can just see this is our application process here. It's a simple application. You get your approval with your up-to limit amount. You create your account. At that point, it's just a couple of steps. So. What we're utilizing Flinks for in the middle here is you're logging into your bank account, and we're using that to set up your payments once the loan is up and running, and also verify your identity in the happy path. After that, all you have to do is go and sign the loan agreement, and at that point, you're ready to spend. And you can be up and running in minutes. You can take your barcode straight to the POS in any Home Depot. You can use the full card number on the left. Online or with an installation services person in your home, and you can look at your purchase balance and all the other relevant detail as to how the loan is, how much you've spent, and how much you're going to be owing at any time. So, results on this. Early results are the good is that we've had a fantastic response from Home Depot headquarters, employees, and customers. It's really taken off. It's beating our best case volume estimates, which I thought were optimistic, to be honest. And we're already issuing millions in credit every month. The bad is, there's always some learnings with every new product. The fraud is a bit higher than we had anticipated, and we also underestimated the operational costs associated with the product line, right? So anytime you build something brand new in a company, sometimes you forget that you have to devote whole new lines of staff to support that product once it's done. That's about everything I got. So I guess I will take some questions now. That was the behind the scenes story. Thank you.
Hello, okay. Not sure if we can talk about this too much, but I'm just curious if your credit approval process differs from that of like a traditional loan or line of credit or credit card.
Yeah, so I mean, on the back end, finance it works with kind of big banks in Canada, so they won't let you do anything other than traditional methods, right? So we are using the bureaus as our primary sources of information when kind of assessing your score. But we only lend to prime, right? We're prime lenders, so.
Can you speak to the operational, how it worked in terms of training all of the staff for the enterprise project?
You mean at the Home Depot?
Correct.
Yeah. So that's definitely a challenging thing for us. I mean, we're still not even a huge company for that. But we do have what we've developed in our operational team as a training team that goes out. And now we have a full-time kind of sales associate that is literally just traveling Home Depot across Canada full-time, promoting and raising awareness for our brand, working with the store managers, with the installation service heads, and making sure that we're training every day somewhere else in the country. It truly is a non-stop kind of a journey in terms of really bringing up awareness in such a big company.
Hi.
We have two?
Sorry, somebody ahead of me. So there are a number of POS lenders out there. I mean, Purpose Financial just announced acquiring Credit Genie today. What's different about your approach to this space versus the handful of others?
Yeah. So I think, I mean, in the Canadian market especially, I think it's our focus on home improvement. It is a different market. It's a very different type of product. You know, you're seeing with the Home Depot, you got to have to support in-store, in-home, online. You have to support the workflows of the contractors as you're going through it. And a lot of these contracts, a lot of these jobs take months, right? When you're getting a big reno done, it can take 6 months. And you got to get approved up front, and you're not getting funded till the end. So, you know, it really is a differentiated product and because of the customer set that we're working with and the reason that they're taking the loan out. Hi. Oh, wait.
Hi. So who is running, like, the risk of the loan? Is it the bank? Is it you? So ultimately, is there, a recourse? And
yeah.
Typically, till now, what sort of default rates have you seen, if any?
Sorry, what was the second part of the question?
The default rates, like, people, like, using the card and not paying up.
Yeah, well, I can't go into the default rates because that's proprietary, but I can say that risk is shared in our model between us and the banks. So, you know, we contribute a certain amount for every loan towards a cash reserve, and we maintain a certain amount of the risk. And if losses get too high, we're going to absorb more, right? And the banks absorb the rest. So it's a partnership. We both have skin in the game.
Awesome. Thank you so much. That was great.
All right. Thank you.